The nation's also sweltering, as you were talking about with Ariel. They're under sweltering heat. In Thailand, the weather agency has warned temperatures could exceed 40 degrees Celsius this week as locals endured searing heat and humidity. At least 30 people have died of heat stroke in Thailand this year. In neighboring Cambodia, temperatures are forecast to hit 43 degrees Celsius, while in Vietnam, the mercury is expected to hit as high as 41 degrees. In Bangladesh, millions of students returned to schools amid the extreme heat wave. Schools were closed last week due to high temperatures. The Weather Bureau there warned the heat wave will continue for at least three more days. The United Nations Weather Agency has said Asia is warming at a particularly rapid pace due to climate change. Well, in southern China, a tornado struck the city of Guangzhou, killing five people and injuring 33 more. Around 140 factory buildings were also damaged, but no houses collapsed. Hailstones the size of golf balls also battered farmlands and residential areas in Guangdong. Over in the U.S., at least four people are dead, including an infant, following a tornado outbreak in Oklahoma. Dozens of twisters swept across the U.S. southern plains, with more than 7 million Americans under tornado warnings Sunday. Storm warnings were also issued for more than 47 million people from East Texas to Illinois and Wisconsin. The severe weather is expected to continue until Monday. Thousands of supporters of Spanish Prime Minister Pedro Sanchez marched in Madrid, urging him not to step down. Sanchez stunned the country last week after announcing he might quit the premiership after a court launched a corruption probe into his wife's private dealings. He has denied the allegations, saying it was part of a sustained campaign of slander against him and his family by political opponents. Police have arrested the alleged gunman in the killing of radio broadcaster Juan Humalon in Misamis Occidental last year. The suspect was caught in Dipolog, Zamboanga del Norte early Monday morning. Humalon, also known as DJ Johnny Walker, was shot to death during a live broadcast last November 5. Police previously said they were eyeing personal grudge as motive. In sports, the New York Knicks are a win away from advancing in the NBA playoffs thanks to their all-star point guard. Jalen Brunson dropped off a playoff career-high 47 points and added 10 assists in their 97-92 Game 4 victory against the Philadelphia 76ers. After struggling in the first two games of the series, Brunson has been on a tear, averaging 43 points in the last two outings. The Knicks can close out the first-round series with another win at home on Tuesday. Making babies cry is usually a no-no for most of us, but not so for a unique form of sumo, which took place at Tokyo Sensoji Temple Sunday. See, sumo wrestlers from a university club rock babies, while organizers wore colorful masks of foxes and demons for a competition in who would cry first. Around 100 babies joined this year's event. The traditional crying sumo started in 1991. To wish for the health and well-being of children.